Welcome to this video playing chess, Rex. So I need to find a good balance between offbeat and still playable. I had one or two really, really bad openings now, and I don't want that again. So let's see. What is this? Really? This is good. Wow. Okay. I take that. What about d5? You might go e5. Yeah, I'm aware that this is a bit dangerous, but still, okay, it's not even going for bishop d3. Why am I even worrying? Okay. Okay. Yeah, this king is shaky. I know why I don't play e5 normally. F5. How do I get this developed now? Bishop, man, maybe I have to do this. Or e6, that has at least queen h4 sometimes. He even has knight g5 immediately because of queen h5. Yeah. Looks a bit sick, but probably castles is really right. I was thinking I could maybe go for long castling, but I don't have the time for that. Yeah, that's definitely dangerous. He's got lots of attacking potential. Bishop h6 is coming. King h8, queen h3 is immediately lost. Wow. Yeah, one misstep in those shaky openings with the f-pawn and you're toasted, right? Terrible. I mean, it's not lost, I think, but it's just so uncomfortable. They get in it here. He played f3, yeah, which is probably complete rubbish if you know how to handle it. But the way it went out here in this game, I'm just under heavy fire. That looks, maybe that's okay. The knight to f5, that looks like it helps to defend a bit. What? Why is this not losing material? It is losing material. I was lucky. That was a huge attack. Really a huge attack.
Check. Check.
Yeah, got queens traded, always helpful.
White resigns.
Yeah, really, I don't know. I don't know what is good after f3. I don't believe that one bit. Yeah, f3. It looks strange, but he really got a huge game there. Maybe d5 is better. Something like that. Now e4, you're really more flexible. It's some kind of Staunton gambit, but this felt very dangerous. But I cannot avoid taking it now. I have to take. This is just not right, yeah. This is just not looking good. So this, yeah. I was far more worried about Bishop D3, of course. Like, I mean, sometimes you can even do things like that. I mean, not sure if this is on here, but it's very dangerous, everything. But that is also dangerous. So I put this on the board. The engine gives that with the huge advantage. Yeah, Queen H5 probably. Yeah, so something like that is already annihilated. Yeah,
Check.
now you're toast. Can give one
Check.
check, G6 and over. Amazing. Yeah, it's a super strong attack. Even here, yeah, it's very strong. Here, and knight g5 was winning. That was winning already. Yeah. Just goes, can just take here,
Check.
and he attacks with his all his pieces, and this stuff is not playing. And over. Wow. Yeah, it's. Here I'm better, yeah. Now I'm better. He gifted me a couple of tempi, and this is gifting a piece. Yeah, he. I think. I mean, okay, that's an old story. I always say that they play too quickly, but I don't really know. This is a very promising position, and he was like 2 minutes up, so he can easily take like let's say 30 seconds, and trying to really find a good move and not just play the first move that comes to mind. I mean, it doesn't look bad, but well, you're 2 minutes up. Let's say it's 30 seconds for a really good move, and knight g5 is. It's not really difficult to see, yeah. G6 he will take here. It's easy. Like H6 looks also rubbish. Yeah, knight G5 just wins the whole thing. But he played a bit too quickly and led me back into the game. Okay, well, thanks for watching.